Let's talk about the index.html. When your Angular application will start, or you can start through the ng-serve command, then first page will be loaded, which is the index.html, and this is decided by the angular.json, and this is basically a workspace settings. So here it is decided that index page will be src index.html, and the ts file, the main ts file, will be the main.ts. So let's go to the ts, main.ts, and you can see here that first module which will be bootstrap, which is the app module here. So basically this module will be bootstrap. So in the index.html, basically you can see here that it is a selector, and which is the app root, and this selector is defined in the app component.ts here. So you can use any component anywhere through this selector, and you can define the selector. So here app root is defined, and here it in index.html it is utilizing. So basically within this body tag, this app root is appending your whole Angular application within this body tag. So as you can see that in the app module.ts, that first module component, which is the bootstrapping, which is app component. So let's talk about the app module first, then we will move to the component. So as you know that through the main.ts, the bootstrapping module, which is the app module, and in the app module you can see that it is basically a decorator. Basically ng module configure the injector and the compiler and help organize related thing together, like component as you can see, and some other module which is imported here. If you want to import any other module, and basically a feature module, then you can import at this section in the import array. And if you want to import any component, then you can import in the declaration array. So you can also notice that this is basically a decorator, which is the @ng module, and imported via this Angular core, and then it is utilizing in this way. Basically this @ng module take a metadata object that describe how to compile a component template and how to create an injector at the runtime. Basically this ng module, which will be identified the module's own component directive pipes, making some of them public through the export property. So when anywhere, if anyone want to use this or import this module, they can import through this import statement. First and foremost, the module should be exported like in this way, like export class app module. So since this is the exported, that's why in the main.ts it is first it is imported here, and then this app module is utilized as a bootstrap. And similarly this will be valid for other component also. Modules are a great way to organize a application and extend it with capability from external library. Module can be loaded eagerly when the application start, or lazy loaded asynchronously by the router. So here as you know that if you will import any of the external module or feature module in this import array, then that particular module will also be launched when application will be instantiated. It means because app module is the first module which will be bootstrap, so since this will bootstrap, all the thing which is written under the app module will also be launched when application will start. So when the application will launch, then whatever module you will import through this import array, then that will be launched as eagerly. It means all the module and their feature and other component whatever you are utilizing under that module will also be started.